Hello, this is David, Principal Engineer with Dell, and in this video I will be discussing forcing demotion of an Active Directory domain controller. There are a few reasons why you may want to do this, and they all center around the idea that you have a domain controller that can no longer replicate AD with its partners, either because it's tombstoned or because something else is broken and can't be easily fixed. Normally when you demote a domain controller, it needs to contact another domain controller in Active Directory to let it know that it's demoting so that its replication partners won't keep trying to replicate from it. But sometimes circumstances render that impossible. And in that case, you need to do a forced demotion. So we have two DCs in this domain named DC1 and DC2. And DC2 here has stopped replicating with DC1. So we need to force demote it. In order to do that, we go to manage and remove roles and features. Click Next, make sure the right server is selected, and then select the Active Directory Domain Services role. And then confirm, say remove features, and you'll get an error saying the Active Directory Domain Controller needs to be demoted before the ADDS role can be removed. That, of course, makes sense. This is how you begin the demotion, with that little link there that says demote this domain controller. So we click that, and the wizard comes up. And this little checkbox right here is key to forcing demotion. It says force the removal of this domain controller. And I'm just waiting for it to be enabled. As soon as it is, I will check it. And then it says, unless this is the last domain controller in the domain, you must perform metadata cleanup manually after removal. That removes the domain controller's metadata from Active Directory so that other domain controllers know it's gone. Then we have to confirm this. This just says the domain controller is a DNS server and a global catalog. We need to click proceed with removal, then click next. And now we're setting a new local admin password on this server. This is important because once you complete a forced demotion, the server will be in a work group. So you won't be able to log into any domain accounts. You can only log into that local admin account. Now we just confirm what we're doing and click demote. And sometimes this takes a little while. The wizard here shows everything that's going on. It can take a couple of minutes. Sometimes it completes faster than that. But the little blurb underneath the progress bar, not really a progress bar, the little blurb underneath the side-scrolling bar thing tells you exactly what it's doing. It's currently reading domain policy from the local machine. That will update as different tasks are performed during the demotion. Also, that little warning down there that says DNS server service has been detected on the server. Any existing Active Directory integrated zones will be deleted during the removal of Active Directory domain services. That just means they'll be removed from this server. They won't be deleted from Active Directory, of course. So don't worry about that. I should mention that this isn't necessarily the go-to procedure for resolving all replication issues. If you have a replication failure, there may be a better way to fix it. But for something like a tombstone DC, a forced demotion is probably going to be your quickest option. It really does take a little while. I'm going to skip ahead a bit here. There's really not much to see. Okay, there we go. Now we get this little pop-up that says you're about to be signed out, and it's not kidding. It's going to reboot the domain controller no matter what you do. So we click close, and we wait. And in a few seconds, it's going to reboot. There it goes. And once it comes back up, you'll see you're able to log into the local admin account using the password that we just set during the demotion. And hopefully you remember that password. If not, you're going to have trouble logging into this machine. But there we go. Now we can see we're logged in again. The ADDS role is still present, as you can tell, but it has been demoted. Before re-promoting it or even rejoining it to the domain, we do need to perform a metadata cleanup on another domain controller to remove its metadata from Active Directory. Also, if this DC held any of the FISMO roles, now is the time to seize them. We have videos posted on both of those things, performing metadata cleanup and seizing roles, so I don't need to cover those here. Hope you've enjoyed the video. Thank you.